have fallen down again tonight. In this world, it's hard to get it right. Trying to make your heart feel like a glove. What it needs is love, love, love. Everybody, everybody wants to love. Everybody, everybody wants to be loved. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, oh, oh. Everybody, everybody wants to love. Everybody, everybody wants to be loved. Oh, oh, oh.
So there are a lot of things that make Community Call different from other nonprofits. Community Call is about empowering the students to pursue whatever issue is important to them. We don't have an agenda. We go through discussions with the students. They talk about what's important to them, what impacts their lives and their community, and then they agree as a group what issue they want to address. Then they develop an event based off of that to create awareness. And examples of some of those types of events are we've had students who wanted to celebrate uniqueness and acceptance and make it sort of an anti-bullying campaign, and they put on an event at Copley Square Plaza, which happened to coincide with the Pride Parade Day. And the event was games and it was art projects, and they had tons and tons of people come from all different types of backgrounds, and it was a wonderful day. Then we've gone and we've done other things, like have a program that was done by youth from the Reengagement Center in Roxbury, and what was important to them was the homeless youth issue, and that's because many of them were homeless. And what they decided to do was, theirs was a little bit more political, they wanted to actually provide feedback what it was like living on the streets of Boston as a homeless youth to the mayor of Boston, to the Boston Public Health Commissioner. So they organized an event at Copley Plaza, and they brought in over 80 youth from around the streets of Boston and Cambridge to come in, solicited their feedback, and then gave it to a panel to the mayor, which was later adopted as a basis for making changes in how the homeless youth issue is dealt with in the city of Boston. So again, the students don't have an agenda when they come in, but they develop an agenda once they come in, and then they work on their own agenda. And that's what makes Community Call unique. Every class is different in terms of the students, their backgrounds, their stories, their experiences, and every event is a unique reflection of what that group brings together. And I think that makes for a very strong moment in the program. There are a lot of moments that are really special with this program that stand out to me, and it's really hard to pick out what all of those moments would be. We had done a program with Harvard at the Harvard Ed Portal on youth suicide awareness, and two of the students in the group had been survivors of suicide. One had lost a parent, and the other one had made an attempt herself. And the testimony that they gave, talking about for the first time publicly their experiences with suicide, was absolutely amazing. And I think what they bring home, whether it's the student who was talking about what it was like to be living on the streets and sleeping in the Boston Common, to being a survivor of suicide, Community Call, one of the amazing things that transpires in our classes is as the students get comfortable with each other and they bond, they become more and more trusting, and the raw honesty that comes out could bring you to tears on many days because of what they say. But the fact that many of them are dealing with trauma, dealing with issues in their neighborhood, possibly issues at home, and they're able to feel comfortable to come here and speak what's on their mind and talk about these issues, that's what always strikes me as the most moving and strongest point of the program.
Put eyes open.